Quit shaking. Emmanuel says it's the red wire. So that's the one you cut.
You cut it yourself. I'll go stand there around the corner.
Piss your pants already? Then watch a real man.
Well, if you're a real man, why are your hands shaking?
Hands don't mean shit. The important thing is nothing else shakes.
What?
Shit! I'm shit!
Shooting is one thing, but we can't burn people alive.
What do you mean? People? Shooting? Are you out of it?
Aren't you talking about the refugees?
What refugees? Let the special department handle them. I'm talking real rats, tails and all.
What the?
They multiply like crazy. You can do it. On the double.
Yes, sir.
What the?
What the hell?
you accept the delivery and sign the manifest?
Sure, who's there?
And put it down! Fuck you on your tray! I almost ruined my new pants!
Thank you so much. You're very generous.
Shut up and think of a way to fix this.
What is it?
Are we going to stand here much longer?
No. We should be coming back from the watch soon.
Did you ever do watch duty there?
Yeah, it's a creepy place. The station's nearby. Machine gun, searchlight, the combo.
Why not burn those kids?
Stay down, or your brain goes splat. Wait a minute. Artyom, is it you?
I was able to send a report back to the Order via my old acquaintance, Andrew the Blacksmith. At least Miller will know that I am alive, that I haven't completed the mission, but haven't resigned from it either.
Everything's cordoned off here, but I believe the Order has an outpost nearby, on the surface, the church in the marshes. Try that place. If we can get word to your people, they might meet you there. As for me, I started life anew, left Kuznetsky Most. The Reds completely subverted the place, looking for traitors and spies, sending people to camps, or just shooting them. All because of the coming war. People are fleeing from Kuznetsky Most and their whole Red Line. Did you see the armored train the Reds are building? Well, we built something too, with the stuff the refugees are bringing. Here, take a look. At this baby. The boys even gave her a name. You can't help but fall in love with her. She did a swell job running refugees. But hell, you can't save everyone. So, take it. We have people in Venice, too. When you get there, find Woodpecker and tell him where you left our baby. Climb aboard. All right, start the engine. We're still tinkering with her, so the controls aren't perfect. But the lights are first class. No need to fear the spider bugs around her. And there's a lot of those in the far tunnels. You should go. It's a long way, so you shouldn't waste any time. Thank you.
Pavel's group is advancing towards Tretikovskaya, also known as Venice. They have a few hours lead on me and are moving via frequently used tunnels, but I will catch up. I can't afford not to.
We're armed.
We are armed. Swear by Lenin's name.
He doesn't look like a GB. I don't recognize the uniform.
Could he be one of ours? Look at all his weapons.
Don't shoot. We are civilians. There are women and children here. Leave and let leave, okay?
We're refugees from the Red Line. I'm in charge here, basically. Now there's nobody under my command. All the battle-worthy men went with the other caravan. Half a click ahead. I thought they'd protect us, but they were attacked. We heard the shooting. It subsided. But it doesn't look like people survived. So we can't go any further. And if we go back, it's the firing squad for us. You look like you've seen your share of fights. Can you help us? It's not for me, but I pity the children.
So what do we do now? How do we live without them?
They might still be alive. Don't bury them yet.
But the shooting... The shooting was so loud. And now...